parents bought a property here in 1954. My mother was Belgian and my father was Indian, and I was born and brought up in Binsir. So in my growing up years, I learned the local language, the customs, spent a lot of time in the villages, even went to school initially in the primary school in the village. And so I think that initial childhood period, when I was really, you know, connected with the village people and their life and cultures, really helped me later on to be able to do what I did, you know. The first thing that struck me was, you know, how the women were the ones who had to slave from morning to evening, collecting firewood, collecting fuel from the forest, collecting fodder for their animals, and everything was so heavily dependent on the forests, and they wouldn't really get any benefit out of that because it was backbreaking labor for nothing. The cows would give maybe, you know, half a liter of milk at best. So, you know, the idea to set up some alternative livelihood for the women in the areas around the sanctuary came to my head. Then a friend of mine, the daughter of the movie star Danny Kaye, Dina, who is the president of the Danny Kaye and Sylvia Fine Kaye Foundation, came to India on a mission to look for programs to fund. And Dina and I spent some time going around India looking at various programs. But eventually she came here and spent, you know, a week up in Binsir at home. And then by the time we'd got really friendly, and so she said that, you know, why don't we do something together? And so then the idea was, you know, really set in motion, because then she put in all the financial backing which was required. And so we started in the villages around the sanctuary, in the villages on the ridge, on the Kasar Devi Ridge. I knew Munni Mehta because, you know, my family had been settled here since 54, and so, you know, one does know a lot of local people. So Munni Di and I decided to go around in the villages, and in those days, of course, nobody had heard of anything remotely like a working woman, you know. Everybody was just at home, a very conservative, very male-dominated society.
हेड में तो कोई भी नहीं है, सारी नीचे गांव की हैं, तो बहुत नीचे जाना पड़ता था, सारे ऊपर चढ़ाई चढ़ना पड़ता था, धूप में जाते थे, बारिश में जाते थे, तो हर औरत के घर घर जा करके हमको औरतों को समझाना पड़ता था. शुरू शुरू में तो लोग इकट्ठा होने को तैयार नहीं हुए, लेकिन धीरे धीरे हमने उनको समझाया कि भैया देखो, तुम सर में लकड़ी का गट्ठा या घास खड़े लेकर के तुम एक एक घंटा तो बात कर सकते हो, लेकिन तुम एक घंटा हमारे पास नहीं आ सकते हो. तो इस तरह मतलब काफ़ी उनको समझाया हम लोगों ने. फिर मैं इस इलाके की बहू भी थी, इस इलाके की लड़की भी थी, तो इसके वजह से लोगों के दिमाग में ये रहा कि फलानी की लड़की जा रही है तो फलानी की बहू जा रही है तो तुम भी जाओ.
I remember the first lot of products they made were totally unsellable. You know, we had to, in fact, we gave all the blankets and everything to the leprosy rehab center because nobody wanted to buy them. They were so bad. And there was always this challenge of, you know, quality. And whenever I would go abroad and trying to, you know, market the goods over here, then people overseas, their reaction would be, oh, we have to help the poor women in India. So, you know, I got very irritated by that. I could understand that point of view, but also the irritation was that people should buy the product just because it's a beautiful product, and the story of Panchachuli would be something which would be separate from that. So then the idea of, you know, getting better wools, going into vegetable dyes, doing something which is exclusive, something which is 100% pure, came into being. And so then we started, Munni Mehta and a group of us started actually trekking across the mountains into Tibet, in the Kailash Mansarovar area, and buying cashmere, raw cashmere, directly from the nomads there. There's a lot of support amongst the women. It's like a big family, and they all help each other, and they're very, very close-knit, no doubt. But once they come into work, then the most difficult thing was to instill that sense of discipline. You know, that if you're working, you're working. Then you're not talking, you're not going around, you know, gossiping about who got married, who got divorced, who ran away with home. You know, that is for lunchtime. So they do have a half an hour's lunch break.
मेरे को मतलब पहले से था यहाँ जाऊँ मैं करके, क्योंकि यहाँ बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत लोगों ने काम किया यहाँ, बहुत लोग आकर के यहाँ मतलब बहुत कुछ सीखते हैं. और ठीक ही है, औरत है ना, हम लोग घर से बाहर नहीं निकल पाते, यहाँ के हमें सब कुछ देखने सुनने का मौका मिलता है.
one doesn't realize is that in the hills it's still very very male dominated. Life is extremely tough for women.
पति कुछ नहीं करते हैं घर में, बीमार है, बीमार रहते हैं, कुछ सास सास की बीमारियां घर ही में रहते हैं, पहले से ही बचपन से तेरा ठीक से, फिर अब वैसे हो गए, 60 साल की उम्र होगी इनकी.
There's a lot of alcoholism, there are a lot of problems, most of the men are always away, so the women are left to fend for themselves, there's a lot of sexual abuse, there's a lot of domestic violence. So all these problems are there, and Panchachuli has kind of shown a path to women who didn't have any hope. That there is something that you know one can do to get out of the rut, as it were.
यहाँ के जब मैं घर में थी तो बिल्कुल एकदम बीमार जैसी थी. यहाँ के मतलब सबसे बोलना चालना मेरी तबीयत भी ठीक रहती है. यहाँ आकर के सबसे बड़ी बात तो ये है मेरी तबीयत ठीक रहती है.
ये मेरा एक सपना था कि मैंने मुक्ति दत्ता के साथ काम किया है तो मैं इसको बहुत आगे के लेवल में पहुँचाऊँ. ये मेरा सपना था और धीरे धीरे ये मेरा सच भी हो रहा है.